On the Crime Watch tonight, an apartment in a quiet Seaside neighborhood was the scene of the city's first murder of the year. Cops were called to the scene on Highland Street around 6:30 this morning. This was the first homicide in the neighborhood in decades. At this point, police are saying they do believe it's an isolated incident. Action News reporter Robert Kapoor is live on scene with the latest.
Well, Aaron, we've been speaking to neighbors here in Seaside all day, and it's still very hard for them to grasp that a homicide took place this morning.
Our back fence is these condos here where the murder took place.
This Halloween, these Seaside neighbors received an October surprise they were unprepared for.
It's so mellow. There's never anything going on over here, really. It's very calm, and it's a beautiful neighborhood. We've never had a problem.
Nothing was out of the normal this morning.
Personally, I have three teenagers and an elementary school son, and they run around the neighborhood, play, and, you know, it's safe. You know.
But around 6:30 a.m., this 25-unit apartment complex on Highland Street was the scene of Seaside's first homicide of the year. Police responded to a 911 call and found 60-year-old Dan Gibson lying on the cement, writhing in pain. He apparently fell or jumped from his third-floor balcony. Moments later, police made another discovery in Gibson's condo.
Well, officers forced entry in and found a deceased woman in the apartment.
The name of the deceased woman is not being released pending the notification of her family. Gibson sustained head, arm, and hip trauma from his fall and was airlifted to a San Jose hospital. He is now in custody and is the prime suspect in this apparent homicide. The whole ordeal is a real shock to neighbors, many of whom have lived here for decades without incident.
We've had no complaints from the neighbors or area, and it's just, like I said, it's just unfortunate, you know, hear something like this.
Yeah, anytime there's a police car in the neighborhood, it probably gets everybody's attention.
We don't have police cars in our neighborhood much. We don't even see them drive by, so this is kind of... Yeah, it's unusual.
Yes, it is an isolated incident. This is a very quiet neighborhood. I've been here 25 years, and the calls for service of this, particularly of this nature, up in that area are very, very few and far between.
Now, police just concluded their investigation, their initial investigation, about 30 minutes ago. They, in fact, actually boarded up the apartment in question where the murder took place. The suspect in custody is considered the only person that took part in this particular crime. He has no criminal record. Investigators are still trying to determine the cause of the woman's death. Aaron?
All right, Robbie, thank you. And we did talk to neighbors in this particular area, and they said, you know, they're shocked by this. They say it is really the first homicide that they can remember in at least 30 years.